मैथमेटिक्स एक्सरसाइज 5.1, वी हैव डन अप टू क्लास क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, वी शैल डू नाउ फ्रॉम 6 ऑनवर्ड्स. फाइंड ऑल पॉइंट्स ऑफ डिसकंटिन्यूटी वेयर एफ इज डिफाइंड बाय एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू 2x प्लस 3 इफ एक्स इज लेस देन इक्वल टू 2 एंड 2x माइनस 3 इफ एक्स इज ग्रेटर देन 2. नाउ हियर यू आर गिवन टू कंडीशंस, ओके, टू फंक्शंस विद टू कंडीशन, एक्स लेस देन इक्वल टू 2. सो when you have to find the continuity or discontinuity, you have to check for x is equal to 2 first. So when wherever there is among these two, here there is equal to, for x equal to 2 I will use this function, and for limit I will use this function without the equal to sign. Okay, so remember that where equal to sign is there, we shall use the function for that value f of c, and where there is no equal to sign, you use for the limit. Okay, so now I'll use for x equal to 2, I will find. So for x is equal to 2, I'll put x equal to 2 in the first function. So f of x equal to 2x plus 3, so 2 into 2. Okay, I'm going to put 2. So 2 into 2 plus 3, so 2 into 2 is 4 plus 3 is 7. Now we have to find the limit. So limit x tends to 2, f is equal to, I will use the second function. Limit x tends to 2, 2x minus 3. So put 2 here, so 2 into 2, 4. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Now here is 7 answer, here is 1 answer. Both the answers are not equal. Since both answers are not equal, we say that f of a 2 is not equal to limit x tends to 2 fx, that means function is discontinuous at x is equal to 2. Question number 8, fx is equal to modulus of x divided by x and when x is not equal to 0, and 0 if x equal to 0. Now here they have said x not equal to 0, so I will divide this plus here modulus of x. So I am going to divide this x less than 0 and x greater than 0. Okay, so for x greater than 0, okay, I'm taking x greater than 0 means it is positive value. So modulus of x will be positive, that is x, and x will be positive. So x by x is 1. So when x is greater than 0, the value of this function is 1. And when you take x less than 0 means negative. So fx is equal to, instead of modulus of x, minus x. And this also minus x. But modulus of minus x, so all minus x or plus x, it is same only. So it is x, but this will become minus x. So I get x divided by minus x and equal to minus 1. Okay, so now you say this is 1, this is minus 1. This I will use, since it is x greater than 0, I will use for right hand side, and this I will use for left hand side, x less than 0. And I will take continuity for x is equal to 0. So f of 0, for 0, when you take 0, it is x equal to 0, answer is given. So I will take f 0 is 0. Okay, now let's find left hand limit. So left hand limit, limit x tends to 0, fx. Limit x tends to 0 minus, but minus sign gives you that left hand limit. Okay, and for left hand limit I will use this function x less than 0. So answer I had solved before, it is minus 1. So I put minus 1, no x here existing, so cannot put the value, so minus 1 answer. Okay, now right hand limit, limit x tends to 0 plus fx equal to, instead of fx, now I will put, for x equal to g greater than 0, I will put that value I have found here, so fx will be plus 1. Again there is no 0, no x, so just put x well, 1 will become 1. Now this is minus 1, this is plus 1, both answers are not same. So left hand limit and right hand limit are not same. So the function is discontinuous at x is equal to 0. Plus it is not equal to even f of 0. Okay, so it is by the condition of the, by definition of the continuity, the function is not continuous at x equal to 0. Question number 10. Fx is equal to x plus 1, x greater than equal to 1, x square plus 1, x less than 1. Okay, so now here, see, again here equal to, for, so for x equal to 1, I will use this function, x is less than 1, so I will use for the limit. Okay, again here 1 and here, no, if I see the inward in interval, x belongs to R. Okay, how? See, for x greater than 1 means minus infinite to 1, I can use this, plus for x greater than 1, that is 1 to infinite, I can use this function, that means x is taken from the minus infinite to infinite, means from the R. Okay, now let us check for f is equal to 1 first. So f of 1, I will use the first function. So 1 plus 1 is 2. Then for limit, x tends to 1, f is equal to limit x tends to 1, x square plus 1, the second function. Put x square as 1, 1 plus 1 square is 1, plus 1 is 2. Both the answers are same. So you can say the function is continuous at every point. Okay, every point in R. So therefore there are no point of discontinuity. At all the point it is continuous, plus they are polynomial. And x is given in this condition, but that also belongs to the real number. Question number 12. f x is equal to x power 10 minus 1, x less than equal to 1, and x square if x is greater than 1. Okay, so now for x equal to 1, I will use this function, and for limit, I will use this function. Okay, so for x equal to 1, use this function. So I put instead of x, f of 1, so I put 1, 1 power anything is 1, so 1 power 10 is 1, minus 1 is 0. Then limit x tends to 1, fx. So limit x tends to 1, put this function x square, put x square is equal to 1, so 1, 1 answer is 0, 1 answer is 1. Again, it is not according to definition of continuity. So since f1 not equal to limit x tends to 1 fx, function is discontinuous at x equal to 1. So it is only one point of discontinuity. Question number 14. Fx is equal to 3 if 0 less than x less than equal to 1. 4 if 1 less than x less than 3. 5 if 3 less than equal to x less than equal to 10. Okay. So now here, see, I have got 0, but 0 has got only one value, not given right hand side. So I will check for 1, because x is less than 1 and 1 is less than x. So it is given for left hand side and right side. So I will take this value 1 and this value 3. So I will check for 2 points, x equal to 1 and x equal to 3. So for x equal to 1, when it is equal to 1, I will use this function. So f of 1 is equal to 3. There is no x, so I don't have to put anything. So answer will be 3. And for limit, I will use the second function, x less than 3, this one. So limit x tends to 1, fx is equal to limit x tends to 1, 4, because function is given as 4. No x, answer is 4, 1 answer is 3, 1 answer is 4. So function is discontinued at x equal to 1. Same way x equal to 3, so when I take 3 equal to, then I will take this function. So f of 3 is equal to 5, because 5, there is no x, this answer is 5. And for limit, I will use this. So limit x tends to 3, fx is equal to limit 4, x tends to 3, but again 4, no x, answer is 4. 1 answer is 5, 1 answer is 4, so discontinued at x equal to 3. Number 16, fx is equal to minus 2 if x is less than equal to minus 1. 2x if minus 1 less than x less than equal to 1. 2 if x is greater than 1. Okay, 3 conditions are given. So here I will check for minus 1 and 1, because here less than equal to minus 1 and minus 1 less than x. So I will take for minus 1 and here also 1, 1. So I will take for 2 points 1 and minus 1. So for x is equal to minus 1, I will x less than equal to, so I will use this function. So f of minus 1, this function is minus 2, no x, so this is the answer. For limit, I will use this function. So limit x tends to minus 1, fx is equal to limit x tends to minus 1, and I will use 2x. Put the value of minus 1, so 2 into minus 1, minus 2, answer is minus 2, minus 2, continuous. Then for x is equal to 1. So for x equal to 1, I will use the function this, and for limit, I will use this. So f of 1 is equal to 2x, put the value of 1 as x as 1, so 2 into 1 is 2. And limit x tends to 1, fx is equal to limit x tends to 1, I will use the second function, 2, and answer is 2. Okay, so this is 2, this is also 2. So all 4 answers, this and this is same, this and this is same. So we can say that function is continuous at minus 1 and 2, or function is continuous at all the points. F of minus 1 equal to limit x tends to minus 1 fx equal to minus 2, and f of 1 equal to limit x tends to 1 fx equal to 2, so continuous. Question number 18. For what value of lambda function is continuous at x equal to 0? What about continuity at x equal to 1? The function is given here. Fx is equal to lambda x square minus 2x when x is less than equal to 0, and 4x plus 1 if x is greater than 0. Okay, so for x equal to 0, I will use this function, and x greater than 0, this. Now here, they have said that function is continuous. Function is continuous means f of c is equal to limit x tends to c, fx is true. Okay, so given that fx is continuous at x equal to 0, that means this is satisfied. F of 0 is equal to limit x tends to 0, fx is true. So we equate and we'll start. So f of 0, since x equal to 0, I will use this function. So I'm writing lambda x square minus 2x. Limit x tends to 0, for the second one, I will use this function 4x plus 1. Since it is for 0, I'll put 0 and 0. So 0 minus 0 is 0. So here comes lambda into 0. Here also there is no simplification. Put the value of x tends to 0. So 4 into 0 plus 1. What I get, this side is lambda into 0 is 0. This side is 1. 0 equal to 1, which is not possible. Since it is not possible, we can say that for no value of lambda, function is continuous at x equal to 0. Okay. Now, they have also asked, what about x equal to 1? So for x equal to 1, see here, since x equal to 1, which is greater than 0, so I will use only this function, because as greater than 0 is 1, 1 is greater than 0, so for that only I have got choice of one function, that is this, for 1 also and for limit also. Okay, so I will use only this function. So let us prove here. F of 1 is equal to 4 into x, that is 4 into 1 plus 1, so 4 plus 1 is 5. For limit x tends to 1, fx equal to limit x tends to 1, 4x plus 1, 4, again no simplification, so put 1, 4 into 1, 4 plus 4 plus 1 is 5. Both the answers are same, and plus in this lambda is not at all involved. So what we can say, for any value of lambda, function is continuous at x equal to 1. So x equal to 1, function is continuous. You can take any value of lambda, as function for x equal to 1 does not depend on lambda. Question number 19. Show that function defined by gx is equal to x minus square bracket x is discontinuous at all integral points. This means the square bracket x means greatest integer function less than x. Okay, it has got some qualities. We start from here, we can take one value a. So limit x tends to a plus, we'll find left hand limit and right hand limit. So I put g of x. So limit x tends to a plus x minus x. I will find first a plus. Okay, a positive, right hand limit. So instead of x, I'll put a plus h using the right hand limit minus instead of x, a plus h. Okay, so now when I'm using this, the next will be a plus h plus a minus h. Okay, I'm opening that bracket, answer will come a minus h. So a and a you cut, h and h you cut, so answer is 0. Now left hand limit will be x tends to a minus gx, limit x tends to a minus x minus square bracket x. Okay, so comes limit, I'm changing the h tends to 0. Okay? I'm changing the limit from 0, x to 0. C minus h minus square bracket c minus h. So here c minus h, and this c minus h, then this integral when I open, it will become c minus 1 value. So c and c cancel out, put the value of h as 0, so when you put h as 0, answer comes minus 1. This answer is minus 1, other answer is 0. Both the answers are different, so you can say the function is discontinuous at every integral points. Thank you very much.